But you are what you are in this world. That's either one of two things. Either you're somebody, or you're nobody.
A lot of this is behind the scenes or under the hood.
It's time to just look under the hood. No stone should be unturned.
I don't even know what that means. Look under, I got an engine underneath my hood.
Most important thing in business is honesty, integrity, hard work, family. Never forgetting where we came from.
Hey, pop the hood.
Pop the hood?
Pop the hood.
Welcome to the Under the Hood podcast with Jonathan Hood.
Welcome to the Under the Hood podcast with me, Jonathan Hood. Thanks so much for downloading the podcast. We have so much fun being able to bring you unique interviews, some interviews that you normally would not hear from those in sports and entertainment. And today we get a chance to talk to Shawn Wayans of the Wayans family. The Wayans family is a terrific family of entertainers and producers and DJs. Shawn Wayans was SW1 on the hit TV show In Living Color on Fox. He was one of 10 kids, one of 11 kids, 12 kids. There was so many kids in that family when he's growing up in the ghetto of New York City. He's an actor known for being in White Chicks in 2004, Don't Be a Menace to South Central While Drinking Your Juice in the Hood back in 1996, Little Man, and so many other shows. The thing about the Wayans family, for me, is that they are willing to try anything, and if it sticks, it's going to work. But the thing that you always know, it's not about drama, it's about comedy with the Wayans family. Shawn Wayans, part of a very talented family in Hollywood, is going to be at the Chicago Improv, chicago.improv.com to get your tickets. He's going to be in Chicagoland, in Schaumburg, Friday, November 2nd, two shows, 8 and 10:15, and November 3rd, 7 and 9:15, go to chicago.improv.com. For tickets, the very talented Shawn Wayans on the Under the Hood podcast. Coming up at the Chicago Improv, go to chicago.improv.com. You'll see Shawn Wayans there. Two shows, Friday, November 2nd at 8 and 10:15, and also on November 3rd, 7 and 9:15. Go to chicago.improv.com to see the great Shawn Wayans. He's with us here on ESPN 1000. Shawn, as always, we appreciate it. Thanks so much for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me. What's up?
What's up, man? How much are you enjoying life right now?
I love life. I'm enjoying it.
Tell me why. Why is life wonderful for you right now?
Life is, anytime you have life is wonderful. Period. Mm-hmm. It's a gift from God. So, you know, I do what I want to do. I love doing comedy. I've been fortunate enough to be able to do it and, you know, have a really strong fan base and people support me and help me to, you know, fulfill my dream. So I'm happy.
You just came back from doing some work with the Improv in Ontario, California. How was that for you? I think it was last weekend.
Yeah, that was just past weekend. It was great. Just a lot of traffic driving all the way down there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but it was great.
Especially with, you got Dodger traffic, you got Laker traffic, and then people trying to get to you.
Yes, all that stuff. Yep, you're right. It was crazy.
I always see you interviewed and people ask you about your family and your upbringing. But my question always has been, like, as you and your other producers and people around you try to figure out different concepts for television shows and digital, I'm just thinking, like, your life is a television show, right? I mean, if anything else, as you guys try to figure out what the concepts that you want, wouldn't your life and your family's life be a great television show?
Are you talking about like us growing up?
Yeah.
I think it would make great TV too. We talked about something like that. We developed something like that. One of these days, we'll get it popping.
Yeah, I mean, so because every interview I see is about you and your upbringing. So for those that don't know, tell people about how, your brothers and sisters and how creative it was just in that household with so many people at one time.
It was an interesting time. It was 10 of us in New York City in the 70s. We didn't really have much. Well, what we did have was each other and laughs. And that's what got us through all our tough times was we were in there creating laughs for each other. And it was fun. And then a lot of the stuff that we used to do to make fun of each other when we were kids somehow ended up making its way in some of our work. You know, there was characters that we used to make fun of people and do impressions of people inside our house. And then some of those people ended up on in Living Color and stuff like that. So
don't forget, Sean's going to be at the Chicago Improv. Two shows on Friday, two shows on Saturday, November 2nd and 3rd. Go to chicagoimprov.com and get your tickets now. And plus, it's at the Improv in Schaumburg. So get your tickets early and get there early, too. Don't be out there like I was, you know, trying to see Deion Cole and like hurting my gaiters, standing out in the cold waiting for him. Get there early so that way you're not dealing with it.
Hang on now. You shouldn't have had no gaiters on in Chicago in the cold, man. You know better than that.
Well, I mean, you got to look good. I
mean, you look good. Can't you put some furry shoes on? You would have been better off wearing Uggs. At least you would have been warm.
That's true. I guess it's about comfort over fashion in that regard, right?
Yeah, gators in the cold, man. Are you kidding me?
Yeah. Who is the funniest person in your family, Sean?
My mom. Yep.
Tell me why.
Miss Wayans is the fun. She's raw. She's raw. Mm-hmm. She's that's where we get all about our wit and all that stuff from is my mom.
That's really awesome. So I want to know about your behind the scenes too, because it's one thing to be in front of the camera, in front of the mic, but about writing and producing, how fulfilling is that for you? That side of the business. And tell me about your first experience about trying to, you know, enhance others by being a writer or a producer.
I'm sorry, half your question got cut off, brother. Say that again.
How fulfilling is it for you to be a writer or a producer, being on that side of the business instead of just being in front of the camera?
I always loved. I was always fascinated by the writing and the creating and putting the show together. Ever since I got into the game, I always learned early on how important it was. My brother told me that's how you control your own destiny is by being a creative. So, I was always fascinated by that. And it's a fun process. And, you know, it not only does it help you, you know, shape where you want to go, but you're also able to find new talent and, you know, create something for them that can launch them into, you know, becoming a star as well. So it's really gratifying in that way.
What was your first experience as a writer or producer for television?
I was a writer trainee on In Living Color. So I was a WGA writer that was like a writer's kind of like a writer's program that Keenen had created for that show at that time. And they bring on two writers to come in and sit with the professional writers and learn the process and pitch. And, you know, that's where I got I cut my teeth. Early on in my career.
Sean, if you had to step into a club right now, could you do a DJ set right now?
Yeah. Yep.
Would you, did you prefer as a DJ, as SW1, did you prefer vinyl or computer? Because if the house, the home of house music is Chicago. And so those that could just bring in like crates of records, you're probably more impressed with that than the person on the computer. Could you do both?
On A Living Color, we was doing it. It was on a track. So there was neither one. You know, I had vinyl lookalikes on the actual turntables, but when you're on TV, it's to a track,
right?
Especially back then. You know, I love vinyl, but I appreciate the convenience of the the Serato, because you don't have to carry all that stuff and you know, it does make stuff simpler. At the end of the day, I think it comes down to playing good music, whether it's on vinyl or digital.
If you have your boys with you, though, that can help you with some of those vinyls, get it out of the trunk, though. I mean, it is more impressive when you come
it
out
is,
there.
Oh, it's very impressive. I'm just talking about, you know, is there something said for the new technology and how much more convenient it has made things? Yes, it definitely has. But vinyl also has a sound to it that sound doesn't have. You know, there's a special kind of feel to vinyl records versus the digital.
There's no question about that. So I want to know, when you're in a hotel flipping channels, how often do you stop and see one of your movies? It's on like every, I could see one of your movies every day if I wanted to.
In a hotel, I don't see my movies at all, to tell you the truth. It's mostly, you know, watching TV in the hotel is either you watching the news or reruns of Big Bang Theory or something like that. you don't really get many options. You know, then they have the movie side where you can watch some Netflix or something like that. But for the most part, you're pretty limited. If I'm home, every now and then I'll see a movie of mine on. But I don't really watch a lot of TV. I'm more creating than watching television.
Every time a movie comes on syndication, you do get paid, right? There's a check that comes in?
There's supposed to be one.
wait a minute now. So when I see...
Hey, man, there's supposed to be one.
All right. Well, where are they? I mean, you might want to check the mailman. I mean, if scary movie comes on...
I'm not saying that I don't get it. I'm just saying that there's supposed to be one. So okay. I'm saying that... Yes, I get a little something. Do you get everything you're supposed to get? I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you want me to check in that for you, or do you have that handled?
No, I'm straight. You just asked me a question. I'm just telling you, you know, my take on things.
Okay, all right. Shawn Wayans is going to be at the Chicago Improv. Two shows on Friday, November 2nd and also November 3rd. We ask you to go to the website chicago.improv.com to get tickets to see Shawn Wayans in Schaumburg. As far as the business behind the scenes with In Living Color, obviously a show that we all grew up watching, and it was just so much fun. I want to know, and for those that don't know, we're talking about Fox Television in its infancy when there was just so much terrific TV. Was there ever a conversation about the growth of the show and the ratings of the show every week as the show continued to build?
I wasn't really privy to those conversations. That was Keenen and Fox at that time. I just know the show was doing well, and you know, I was, you know, a kid, happy, you know, sitting around a lot of great talent and just sitting around laughing all day.
Do you think that show will ever be replicated? It was just that good. I'm not sure if there can be a show that on that level to come back again.
You know, I'll never say never. I don't know. I don't know what's to come. I don't know who's out there in the lab, you know, creating something else that might be something, you know, just as good or better. You just don't know. I know for whatever In Living Color was, it made its mark. It did what it was supposed to do and launched some great careers and some incredibly talented people. And, you know, it helped to change the world of comedy. So I'm grateful for that.
There's no question about it. You say you don't watch a lot of television, but you know you are fully aware of how there's just this build of terrific black television out there on cable and also on network TV. Is there a show that you know of that you're very proud of that you enjoy watching when you do get a chance to watch?
I don't watch TV. I really don't. I haven't seen, I haven't really sat down to really watch anything. I've been, like I said, especially right now I'm writing and I'm working on my kids show, my cartoon. So I haven't really been watching much television.
The Boo Crew, right?
Yeah. Working on the Boo Crew.
There's people that are talking about the Boo Crew and saying that they want to see more. Can you tell us about the concept of it, and can we see more moving forward?
Well, the concept of it kind of comes from, you know, a young kid growing up, I was influenced by shows like Charlie Brown and Fat Albert and Davy and Goliath. Those shows really had good, valuable lessons in there for me and my little brother that we used to watch that we ended up using in life. And, you know, they helped shape us as young men. So I wanted to give something like that back to this generation. So we created the Boo Crew, which is about nine different kids growing up in Boo York City. the kids are all from different nationalities, African-American, white kids, Asian kids, Latino kids, everybody playing together and learning life lessons together. And, you know, the idea is to teach kids life lessons through humor and music. We shot two specials that aired on Nickelodeon probably about 10 years ago. Then I got busy with a bunch of other stuff. And now I came back to it, and we started our own YouTube channel, and it's on the Boo Crew TV. The two specials are up there, and right now I'm currently directing a third episode and working on some more books. And we got two soundtracks that are on iTunes, and we're working on new music. So, you know, just bringing it back.
I like the kid in the light blue that's eating. That's me right there with the little fro and his stomach hanging out.
Slim, I play Slim. Yeah,
I like him.
He's, he likes Slim. Oh no, you like the way Slim talks. That's what's up.
He's struggling with every breath, but he gets it out though. The lines are there.
He gets it out. He also gets it in.
I like him. So we ask you to go to, we'll put the link out there as well for people to see this on YouTube, the Boo Crew.
And you can follow us on Instagram too at the Boo Crew Official, and more to come. Stay tuned.
Okay, people have been asking like where's more of it, because people are interested in it. So yeah,
it takes a while to do these things. You know, animation takes a while. It's not a quick process, so. But it's coming.
Yeah, it's more than just the voices. It's the animation. It's the color and everything else, right? So it takes
a while. Yeah, it's the animation. It's the animation. It's the design. It's the color. It's the music. It's all that stuff.
What is
there's a live show. I'm also planning on doing a live show of the Boo Crew too. So look for that.
Television?
Nope. Live. Coming live. To you. Concert. Live. Sesame Street. Rugrats. Yes. You know, that vein. Yep. Family entertainment.
Traveling? Going from city to city?
Yeah.
Can you give us that much? Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Is that 2019, 2020? Is that, how far off is that project?
That I can't give you, but it's in the works.
Okay. All right. At least I got that. That's I got an exclusive there. Yeah, that's good.
I'll take that. That's the exclusive. I'll take that.
Okay. I will definitely take that. All right. Absolutely. When you were growing up, were you a Knicks fan? Were you a Knicks fan in the NBA?
You know, I never was like a fan of no real I used to like players. I liked Bernard King and Patrick Ewing.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't really like, I wasn't like a team guy. I just like, oh, I like these guys. Oh, I love Michael Jordan. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not really a sports guy. You know, I like to watch boxing. You know, I watch UFC. But watching sports is not really, you know, I'd rather play sports.
UFC is pretty brutal.
It's very brutal. Like, yes. You don't even have to know the guys, and it's exciting.
That's true. That's true. It's just the action in the octagon. There's no bell. It's just the octagon, a cage, and you're going to try to survive.
Yeah, no champion, no bell. You don't have to worry about nothing, but it's whoever you're watching is going to make you go, damn.
That's true, man. That's true. Somebody gets stuck in the face, and it's like, it's all over.
Ooh, you just got, that's where I just go, man, I'm glad I chose comedy.
Right, exactly. Okay, so last thing, Sean, and I appreciate your time. I want to find out about you doing these stand-ups across the country and coming to Chicago again November 2nd. Two shows, 8 and 10, 15. Get there early. November 3rd, 7 and 9, 15 at chicago.improv.com. Have you noticed over the years the difference in the crowds as far as sensitivity is concerned? Because this has been an issue where I grew up in the 70s, so I'm used to terrific comedy and nothing really offends me. But I know that today there's a heightened sensitivity from audiences and people. Is there a difference that you see over the years?
I definitely see, you know, it's weird because it's like, yes, there is, some crowds are more sensitive than others. And then some of it is more, it's more put out there in the universe that you're supposed to be more sensitive versus are these people more sensitive that's sitting in front of you? Because, you know, I had some great shows and I pushed the boundaries all the time and I didn't see any sensitivity. And then there's sometimes I'll do a show and I'll feel the sensitivity. So it depends on the night and who's in there.
And the city as well, right?
It could be the city, but you know what I'm seeing now more than anything is people want to laugh. Mm-hmm. They're not getting the laugh that they want to get, and they're coming to get the laugh now. You know, there might have been a time where, you know, they might have been more sensitive, but what I've seen lately, they come in to laugh.
Yeah, well, that's good. That's a positive, is because you've seen, like I've seen, where there's fans walking out on George Lopez or walking out on a few other comedians based on one joke, and it's kind of like, well, you're there for comedy. You're not there to laugh.
Yeah, comedy is you know, it's brutal, and it ain't nice all the time, but that's why you're there. You're there to hear that stuff that's going to touch you and make you go, whoa, that was funny. I can't get that everywhere. So, you know, don't go to a comedy club looking for, you know, someone to soothe you other than do anything but to make you laugh. You got to ride with them in order to get that laugh. You can't be judging them like that.
Yeah, that's interesting. Well, I'm glad you spent some time. I'm glad you're here in Chicago. I will be there Saturday night to check you out. So I'm so glad you stopped by the show. And again, chicago.improv.com to get your tickets to see Shawn Wayans. I appreciate it, man.
Thanks for coming on the show. Yeah, I appreciate it. And just try not to walk out on my set, man. Don't be so sensitive, man. All right, John?
Yeah. I'll be glued to my seat.
All right, man. Don't be so sensitive. I seen you walking out the last time, man. Come on, man. Thicken up that skin.
Okay. All right. I will. I'll stand right, in bro. And watch you, man. Thank you.
All right, buddy. Okay. Take care.
You're listening to Under the Hood Podcast with Jonathan Hood.
Great conversation with Shawn Wayans of the Wayans family. Again, Chicago, let me do it again. 3, 2, 1. Great conversation with Shawn Wayans from the talented Wayans family. Go to chicago.improv.com for tickets to see Shawn Wayans. He's got the Boo Crew going. Man, that's on YouTube. We'll put the link out there to see. It's pretty funny. Great concept. We've had some terrific guests on the Under the Hood podcast. Go back in the archives if you missed my interview with Marcellus Wiley of Fox, as well as a new book that he has out. Great conversation about his upbringing in Los Angeles. Got a chance to talk to Malcolm D. Lee. He's got a number of projects coming out. Malcolm D. Lee, the great actor, the cousin of Spike Lee. We got a chance to talk to Fred Mitchell from the Chicago Tribune, many years as a writer. He's got a new book coming out as well. Lamar Rucker from Greenleaf, great actor there. Corey Holcomb, the comedian. Shanola Hampton from the hit television show Shameless. So we've had some great guests. Go back in the archives if you missed some of our interviews right here on the Under the Hood podcast. All right, the executive producer of the Under the Hood podcast is the Dr. Sean Davis. And I will talk to you next time with another edition of the Under the Hood podcast right here.